This notion of maximum variance should strike a little bit of recognition in your mind about the notion of fitting a line. You remember we did line fitting, okay? In fact, we came up with this equation of saying we're going to measure the error that's essentially just the perpendicular error of the points to this line. And the equation of the line that we had there was ax plus by minus d equals 0. Or it could be plus d, it doesn't matter. The idea is that a and b was the normal with respect to the line, and in fact, that's what that says right there. And when I take the dot product of x and y on that, it's supposed to be a distance d away, and that's what this equation says. All right, so that was when we were trying to do a least squares fit. So then we did this quick operation. We took the derivative with respect to the d, came up with this formula for the d in terms of the average x, the average y. We plug that in, substitute d equal ax bar by bar. We get this new error function e, just having substituted, and we wrote it this way, okay? And this is where b is this matrix here. And you can see it's just the x's and y's in rows with the means subtracted, okay? So what we want to do is we want to minimize that quantity, the magnitude of b times n, where n is going to be the normal ab that we're going to solve for. And we said last time that what we want to do is we want to minimize bn squared. But remember, since the normal has to be a unit normal, we say subject to n equal 1. Now, what might be not so obvious, because we didn't mention exactly last time, is that this distance, these square distances, this is going to be the axis of least, let's call the axis of least inertia, right? Remind you from your physics, if I've got an axis, then the inertia of the whole thing is proportional to the sum of all the points, the square distance from those points to the axis. So the line fitting here in 2D is an axis of least inertia. And like I said, this should sound familiar to you. And we remember we did this, we looked at several ways of doing this. We had those, in fact, back when we did calibration, we said, well, we have this AM, because we're doing M matrix for the calibration. We said, let the norm of that, well, we want to make it as small as possible, subject to M equal to 1. And remember, we were doing this thing with eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So it shouldn't surprise you that we're going to be revisiting eigenvalues and eigenvectors.